Hello, I'm Robert from the Dr. B channel on YouTube. How are you? Now, I have changed that bit. I used to call myself Dr. Bubble. From now on, it's going to be Dr. B. That sounds a little bit more plausible than the other monocle. Anyway, in this particular tutorial, I'm going to discuss how to make a landscape using Vertex Paint, as well as using a mix map to combine two maps together to produce a non-linear looking landscape. So let's move on. Before I start, I must say that the video is more or less naturally aimed at everybody, but more specifically for people who are new to Max or for people who have never used Vertex Paint before. So this video is more suited to those kind of people. So first things first, I'm going to make a plane with snaps on and with grid points ticked. I'm going to just make a quick plane. It's under generic units, so not real world. Press S again. Press G and J and press F4. Now, for Vertex Paint to work, I'm going to need some more vertexes naturally. So I'm going to go on to Turbo Smooth and put four iterations and convert that to poly. I'm going to rename this to Ground Mix. Next, I'm going to go to the Material Editor by pressing M and going to Arch and Design and choosing the standard feature map there, or shader. Now I'm going to add this and show this in viewport. Now, for this to work, I'm going to need to add a mix map to the diffuse slot here, so that's the next thing. Okay, I'm also going to show shaded material in viewport as well. Okay, add that and on there. So next up, I'm going to use the Vertex Paint, which naturally I've already set up in my own favorite modifier list here, which I've got a video, so you can go and watch that if you're not too sure how to set that up. Anyway, if you don't want to do that, that's naturally you can go and add it from down on the list, which is down to Vertex Paint. And we're going to press on Vertex Paint. Now I'm going to explain a few features of this rollout here. I'm not going to go right through this. I'm going to add to shaded, and I'm going to go to paint. Now, to make the brush bigger or smaller, you can hold down Control and Shift and the left mouse button and roll up and down, and you see the radius getting larger and smaller. So I'm going to use around 17.5. Go to the top view and we'll start to do some nice painting. There we go. That's, I don't know why it's, that's better. Now I'm going to make some sort of EastEnders intro motif here. For anybody who's not watched EastEnders, that's probably just as well. Now I'm going to make this reduce this size and make some. I don't know why my computer's trying to catch up for some reason. Come on, there we go. That will do. Nothing special. So this is going to be my path, and the white bit's going to be the grass. It's as simple as that. Anyway, we shut that down. And next, we're going to assign some materials, or in, well, not materials, some bitmaps which are going to have material like graphics on them. Anyway, naturally, for the black one, for this black color or this black pathway, we're going to choose a gray dirt. And we're going to do that down to 8 and 8 and turn off the blurring. Okay. Next, for the white areas around here, we're going to add a grass bitmap. These are all standard to the 3ds Max range, especially in the 2011, even though I'm using 2012 here. We're going to do the same thing here, 5 and 5, and turn off the blur. Add that. Okay. Oops. And let's go back to the Vertex Paint. Oops, press yes and hopefully I can get this to come up on the viewport. Let's see. Nope. There we go. So you can see what we're doing now. You're probably thinking, what the hell's this? Anyway, the next thing I can do, I can naturally mix these colours together. So I've got a 50% of grass and 50% of dirt. Now if I do a render now, it's going to produce that mix map effect, which is nothing. It's nothing special whatsoever. Now, if I go to the actual back to standard maps and choose vertex color, this will control the amount of black and white. So naturally I've made a black shape that's going to resemble the path, and now it should give me that effect in the render. There we go. Hopefully you can see that. Nothing special, but this is what the mixed map and vertex painting can do for you. So let's see if I can get that in the viewport. So that's, if you press on here, that's the shaded and that's the unshaded. Let's see if I can get sorry about that. Sometimes they're slightly fiddly, these buttons up here. So also, to manufacture a bit of depth in the map itself, the good thing is I can go to vertex color and choose that and press copy. Go down to maps and we're going to go to displacement and we're going to copy that as a, paste that as a copy. I'm going to use around about 10, I believe was a good one for me. And let's try that. This will naturally give it a bit of depth. The white area is going to be raised and the black areas will be more or less become flat, negative in other words, just like a mask would be or any grey scale. Even that's a little bit too high. Let's go to 5. In addition, you can add more colour. If you go to a greyer tint and paint on this and use a smaller brush, then you can get some different types of mixture going on. There's no work of art, by the way. There we go, something like that. And we can also blur the effect out to give it more of a subtlety. If I do a render again, you can see these small grey bits here going on. The darker it is, the flatter it's going to be in the middle. So there's that. So this is what you can do with vertex paint. Now there's plenty of applications that you can use to make landscapes and so forth. You can paint on your models and paint textures and all sorts of things. Naturally, I recommend looking under Vertex Paint under the Help section in Vidius Max and educating yourself on that. This is just a brief overview of what you can do. Now I have produced a picture that I did. It's nothing special, but I'll show you anyway. If you go to Asset Browser, now this is what I did. Let's make this bigger. So all I've done here is added some of those trees that Max has in its library. I made some rocks, some plants, and I put this very, you could say, unsightly fence into this just to give it a bit of, you know, credence. And made a water plane at the back, and add a daylight system in there. Added a bit of glare in the camera shader. And reduce some of the colours and the contrast, and this is what I got. So you can produce a decent effect, and this is after around 15 minutes work, And to be totally frank with you, it took more time to actually bloody render than it did actually to make it. But that's the way Max treats displacement maps sometimes. It takes a lot of memory and processing power, which I haven't got a lot of. But this is what you can make in a very simple amount of time. You can make it much better than this. This is just an example that I would like to show you. So, anyway, if there's any questions, any comments, please post them. You're always welcome. And if there's any problems using this method, then by all means, again, comment below the video. If you like this video, please put a thumbs up, because it directs other people so they can watch this fantastic video. Only joking. But have a good day, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.